uncles, grandmas, sisters, anybody who knows me in person ever, please click away from this video. I don't want this to be a part of your life. Welcome back. I was in my You Now broadcast and it was brought to my attention from one of my very lovely followers that somebody had written fan fiction about me. If you're not familiar with fan fiction, it's when a fan writes some fiction, some adult content fiction, if you will. Porn, essentially. It was this girl named Megan, and I told her to send it to me, and she told me specifically to not read it, which in my mind said this should be a YouTube video. So what we're going to do together is read this fan fiction, and I'm really scared. All right, it's called That Time I Met Gabby from Vine, written by That Guy with the Weird Fetishes. Oh, there's a summary. That one time I met Gabby from The Gabby Show, and it turned out she's quite insatiable. I'm gonna have to Google that word later. I attached pictures in case you don't know who she is. Oh, that's a nice one. All right, let's dig right in. That whole I'm so lonely and act, is that for real or just a clever way of getting a following? I ask, her brown eyes captivating my attention. Truth? Gabby says, wait, this is my own voice. Why wouldn't I use my own voice? Hold on. Truth, Gabby says, almost a whisper. I'm whispering. Truth, Gabby says, almost a whisper. She looks away, avoiding eye contact. I nod. It's not entirely an act. I know lots of my followers just follow me because of the one in a million chance that I might meet them and them. But if I'm being truthful, I really do feel lonely and I really do need, Gabby trails off,
need to get
I say, finishing her thought. She looks up at me, almost taken aback by bluntness of my words. Her cheeks turn a scarlet color and she nods quickly and turns her eyes away, almost as if she's ashamed to admit how she felt. She wears a snapback with the bill backwards. She's always wearing those things. Never understood why snapbacks made a comeback. Hey! So, what now? She asks, making eye contact again. Her eyes show a hint of desperation. I look in her in the eyes after a short pause and I say, you know what? Our eyes meet and we both know what we want in that moment. We both suddenly stand up, pushing our chairs away. Her lips meet mine and we kiss. Our tongue wrestles in each other's mouths. Ew. She pins me against the wall. I'm not that strong, pressing her body against mine. She's standing on her toes, kissing me. I can't help but find it cute. I never really cared for Gabby as a content creator. I found her vines extremely unfunny and only a few occasionally made me laugh. What is this, my reading mean comments video? So this guy is writing a full-fledged porn about me and he felt the need to include the fact that he does not think I'm funny. He is writing fan fiction about somebody, but he doesn't want anyone to think that he could find my humor. This is so rude. I will admit that when I first saw Vine with Gabby, I couldn't help but find her attractive. So the fact that this moment was happening was quite amazing for me. Shut up, you're a hater. My hands slide down her back to her. I smack her with my right hand and squeeze, eliciting a slight, oh, from the Vine star. I bite her lip and pull. Oh, I can't read that. Oh. I take a look at her voluptuous through her tight-fitting gray and white sweatpants. I don't have gray and white sweatpants. I spank. Oh, fuck, she growls. Oh, fuck. Oh. This is a lot of language. This guy's really obsessed with the word insatiable. That is an interesting turn of phrase. Oh. It's not over? Okay, I wouldn't say that. I wouldn't say that. And I wouldn't do that either. I don't like it. Ouch. I don't like it. Okay, she also sent me this one that isn't supposed to be scary. I'm really sorry if that made you as uncomfortable as it made me. I had to get my computer for this one. She also sent me one that's not raunchy and it's like sci-fi, so I thought that was cute. Who's in it? Oh, it's me, Issa, Cameron Dallas, and Nash Greer, which is cute because those people would never hang out with me in real life. Oh, it's all of our point of view. Oh, it starts with Issa's POV. I hide deeper in the bushes. As I'm hiding, all I can hear the screams of the friends I had already lost. As I feel something rub up against me, I turn to see a dead girl. Oh my god, I hope it's not me. Let me find my point of view. Gabby's POV. I knocked on Issa's door and stood in the doorway. Hey, can I come in? As long as your name is not Nash Greer, you can do whatever you want. Issa snapped. That's actually something Issa would say. I wish Cameron had left him on the side of the road to die. Issa is definitely pissed. I hadn't seen him this pissed off since the day he played Five Nights at Freddy's. Okay, that's a really long one, so I'm gonna have to read the rest of that later. Leave in the comments below what you thought. Give this video a thumbs up for being extremely uncomfortable. This is our relationship now. We do things together. And make sure to subscribe to my channel for more weird things like this and story time. Showstopper of the week is... Oh, I guess my drums are up here now. The girl who sent me the damn things. Actually, she probably wrote it. Let's get serious, you freak. Megan. Megan is always a top fan in my live broadcast, and she's also always in my tweets and retweets, so she's pretty awesome, and just make sure to show her some love and give her a follow. If you want to be my Showstopper of the Week, just make sure you have my post notifications turned on for Vine, Twitter, and Instagram, and you're following me on Facebook and Snapchat, and you're subscribed to my YouTube channel, duh. Anyways, as always, I love you very much, and I'll see you next week.